Welcome back to the homestead, everyone. This video today I've been wanting to make for a long time. I just haven't. I don't know why. It's something that I use on a almost daily basis here in the garden when it's growing season, and that is neem oil and soap. Now, a lot of you already use this, and I've been using this for probably 5 or 6 years now. I heard about it. And neem oil comes from the neem tree, mainly grows in India, and this is cold pressed neem oil. And it really, really works to deter a lot of different insects on your garden plants. Now, in this case, right here, we've got our kale. Our kale was attacked viciously by aphids. And as you can see, this is the damage that they left behind here. It's pretty nasty. And this kale was almost completely devastated. But as you can see behind you, check this out. Look at all this beautiful new growth on this kale. And that is because we knocked those aphids down with this neem oil and soap recipe. Now, this is Dr. Bronner's Cell Suds. This is a natural soap, an organic soap, and it I can't say enough about it. I'll put these both in our Amazon store. This is a Dr. Adorable Incorporated. This is 32 ounces. This is a quart. And actually, I used to use a different brand, but then this one popped up and it's actually a much better price and it works just as good. So you can see this amazing growth here. These aphids were stopped in their tracks. I think I put 2 applications on here and then the new growth from the kale started to come back. Kale's really resilient. To heat and cold and everything, and the aphids were just knocking it back pretty bad, but we got that that solution on it and it works amazingly well. Basically, sprayer's not working here. Basically, you're just gonna spray it on there. I'm gonna give these a good spray for tonight just to keep whatever's out here at bay. Now, I usually mix in this 1.5-gallon sprayer here. I mix roughly 2 tablespoons of neem oil to 1 tablespoon of cell suds or whatever soap. Dawn dish detergent works just as well. I prefer this one because it's more natural, to 1.5 gallons of water. And that ratio seems to work incredibly well for anything I have out here. Beans, we've had some aphids on the beans over here and the peas over here. We've had some, I'm not sure what type of caterpillar or moth larva we've had on our Swiss chard over here to my left, but this worked, not a problem. The only thing that this will not work on that I've found so far, the only insect, are leafhoppers. I know there's another name for it. Thrips, I think it is. I think they're also called thrips. That's what it is. Leafhoppers, more common name. Thrips, second common name. It does not work on them. They are really, really hard to get rid of, and I had those on my beans last year. For that, we used a solution of really diluted orange oil on those. This will also not knock down ants. However, the ants will leave your plants alone if you get the aphids off them. So, not a problem there. All right, thank you everyone for watching. We appreciate it. If you have any questions about the formulation or our ratios, just ask us in below or down below, and I'll put it in the description as well. And be excited that you've got a really natural, organic solution here that you can spray on your plants. Not gonna cost you an arm and a leg, and it's going to knock things off. No problem. No harsh chemicals needed. All right. Have a great day. Don't forget to like and subscribe and go check out some of our other videos on gardening. We're out here every day in the garden. We appreciate it. Have a great day. See you on the next video. Bye.